Hey, this is Dr. Paul, and let me just share with you, if you're a chiropractor, some key points about the Paycheck Protection Program. In other words, this government stimulus program to help you with your business and some of your overhead expenses. So there's a couple interesting points to this. First, it's the basic information. This is the application form here. It's the basic information here, your business name, address. But you'll see that the loan amount can be 2 times, 2.5 times the average monthly payroll. Now, what's interesting about this also is this is not just for payroll. This also includes rent and utilities or leased equipment. So this is not just for payroll. And so the amount is 2.5 times your expenses. And a couple other points that I'll point out here is the let's come down here. This is just basic questions about okay. This is number two, the section 2 and 3 right here. So it says the funds will be used to retain workers and maintain payroll or make mortgage payments. So payroll, mortgage payments, lease payments, utility payments. And I understand that these funds are used for I understand if they are used for unauthorized purposes, it's a criminal fraud charges. Okay. But the point is, it's not just employee payroll. So that's great news. Now, right under it, there's a couple things under it. It says documentation verifying the number of full-time equivalent employees on payroll, as well as the dollar amounts of payroll cost, coverage mortgage interest payments, covered rent payments, covered utilities for the 8-week period following this loan will be provided. So for 8 weeks following this, you're covering it. Remember, if this is a grant, it's free money for your employees. In other words, the government's basically paying for your employees as long as you don't lay them off, which is great news. And by the way, that's one of the two biggest mistakes you can do right now is lay off your employees. Loan, and then here's the other key point here, is loan forgiveness will be provided for the sum of documented payroll cost, coverage mortgage interest paid, coverage rent payments, and covered utilities. It does say, however, due to the likely high subscription, it is anticipated that not more than 25% of the forgiven amount may be for non-payroll costs. Now, there's a couple key words in there. First of all, it says maybe. So, in my opinion, I think eventually that's going to be written off as a grant too, in my opinion. But it says 20 up to 25%. So essentially, they're saying up to 25% of your other costs, your rent, utilities, your lease, your leases, equipment leases, up to 25% of those costs are will also essentially be written off. So that's very good news, and it says the high likelihood. So again, like I think it's actually going to be all of it eventually. But anyway, that's the good news. So it's for 2.5 times your cost, and then it also covers your rent, your utilities, your lease expenses, and up to 25% of that will be forgivable. And even the loan itself is, I think the loan itself, the interest rate is like 0.5% or something like that. It's unbelievably small. So it's definitely worth taking advantage of, even if you're in a cash cow situation. It's still a great situation to take advantage of. So anyway, I just wanted to point this out. And of course, the rest of it is just basic information. Name, address, things like that, and then you're just going into basic information with the rest of the form, with the acts and all that stuff. So this is just basic stuff here. But the key thing that I just wanted to make sure that point out and emphasize, one, it's 2.5 times your amount for that 8-week period. Two, it's the grant for the wages for the employees is 100% written off. It becomes a grant, not a loan, if you don't let the employees go, which you shouldn't do. Again, the two things you should be doing right now when there's an emergency in small business is you tighten down the hatches, you run lean and conservative, Number one, communicate very high with your consumer base. And then number two is you work on putting your systems in place when this gets over, because this will be over in 30, 60, 90 days. This will all get back to normal, even though it doesn't feel like it right now. And so it's a great opportunity to put systems in place to be ready, to have all your systems in place and be ready so when all this ends in 30, 60, 90 days, you just shoot right out of the funnel and you even do better in business. But those are the key points. 2.5 times the loan amount. It's forgiven. The loan's forgiven if you don't let the employees go. And the loan includes, so when you tally this, do not just tally it for your employee payroll, because it'll include at least 25% off. You'll get at least 25% off your mortgage, your rent, your mortgage, your utilities, and your leased equipment. And that's what I wanted to point out to you. So I hope this helps you, but this is the application form, and it's best just to get it, fill it out, and send it to your local bank. It's best to deal with your local bank, that the people who already know you, that you already have account with, and that you already have influence with. That's where you want to go with this. And you want to go there as soon as possible to get on the list, because there's obviously going to be a long list. So hope this helps you out.